Mr. Secretary, hello. We are no strangers to each other. You spend a tremendous amount of time in the Allentown School District, for which I'm very grateful. You've done incredible stuff to try to help our financially strapped school district. In the 5 minutes that we have, I could touch upon a whole host of things. If people want to hear me talk about the building that about 1,000 middle school kids go to school in every day, that was built in 1871. We could do that. I could talk about the schools in my district and throughout the Allentown School District that have lead paint and asbestos. We can certainly do that. We have no shortage of concerns addressing the third largest school district in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, 17,000 kids, roughly 90% of whom are children of color. And of those 17,000 kids, most importantly, two of them are mine. But I'm going to take a slightly different tact and talk a little bit and ask some questions about the proposed charter school reform. As you know, the Allentown School District has some of the highest charter school penetration in the entire Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. Of our $330 million annual budget, over $60 million of which is sent out to charter schools in terms of tuition and support. Is there any wonder that we're constantly facing a double-digit annual deficit? The administration has proposed some pretty interesting reforms. I'd like you to talk about them, but specifically, Mr. Secretary, if you and your staff can address the fact that there's an understanding that charter schools do not impact all 500 school districts equally. There are some school districts like mine that have significant charter school presence and others that don't. How would your administration's proposals address those charter those districts that are higher impacted by charter schools?
Thank you for the question. Over the course of the past 5 years, we've had many conversations around charter schools and charter school reform. And, you know, I think it's always important to start off the conversation with, with a reminder that public charter schools are public schools and fall within the confines of school code and the expectations we've set. And there was a need and there continues to be a space for charter public schools. However, many of the recommendations we're making are a result of a really outdated and old charter school law. So it's really looking to right size, learn from the lessons that we've learned over the course of the past few years. And so there absolutely is a larger proportionate share to some school districts of charter cost than others. Specifically, if you have more kids or more children with special needs attending a charter school, you're going to pay a higher proportionate share than schools or school districts that have a lower percentage. First, one of the biggest recommendations we're making and probably getting, the most attention is looking specifically at the special education formula for charter schools. A number of years ago, over 3 years ago, the General Assembly passed the special education formula for all traditional public schools. And we allocate special ed funds based on the level of need per student. At that time, the General Assembly and the administration did not institute that same formula for charter schools. So as a result, when you look at, specifically when you look at, a charter school that might be serving a level one student, so a student may be receiving 45 minutes to a day, a service a year, and they're being reimbursed on the average of the same rate of a level one or a level three student, which could be $100,000 plus a year. And the payment from the traditional public school is just that average proportionate share of that. Whereas where we reimburse school districts, we look at with new special education funding, we look at the level of funding, the level of need for that student before we provide that special education reimbursement. The governor is also proposing a single fee for cyber charter school students. So, currently if you're a cyber charter school student in one district that has a lower per pupil cost, you could be reimbursed for upwards of $11,000 per child. And in the same cyber charter school, for the same program in another district, you could be reimbursed for $20,000 per child. And so when we look at specifically some of the recommendations that that the governor is making, they've just been recommendations that have not been taken into consideration as we've learned and adopted new policy for public schools. And, you know, and there are some other, you know, proposals that I've asked for. So, for example, the redirect fee, to change the system for redirection. Often we find the department finds itself in the middle of having to remediate between the billing, the invoices of a charter school and the sending school. And there are cases where we have to put a team in place to review accounting for under a dollar, and sometimes it's thousands of dollars. In my opinion, we should set conditions that the charter school and the public school have to work together to remediate and to figure out those invoices, and not pull the Department of Ed, who really doesn't have the personnel to facilitate, just to kind of do that themselves at home.
Very good. Thank you, sir.